Well, we had one semi-final in the University League 3-on-3. Kajalevich University beat McGill by 1 point, and the second semi-final is between Mount Altius Physical Education Institute from Mongolia against the University of Chile. Remember, it's the first team to 21 points or the team that is leading after 10 minutes. And it is the Mongolian side, Mount Altius in white. And you get the offensive rebound. Remember, there's a 12-second shot clock. That's too easy along the baseline. So the Mongolian side by one. That was Badzolo Burgil with an easy two. That's good hustling, but the offensive rebound is grabbed by the University of Chile. The jump shot misses, and Altius get the rebound. Well, everybody called a walk there, or at least everybody from the University of Chile called a walk, but it was just two big steps. University of Chile with the open two and the rebound. Behind the back pass into traffic, though. And Mount Altius get the rebound. Another big step layup. And a three-point lead now for Mount Altius. Mongolia is the cry. And Mongolia get the rebound. That's an easy pass into the low post. And the foul. Remember, no limit on personal fouls in 3-on-3. There is a limit on team fouls, though. If you get to six, they're shooting fouls. And we have a shooting foul on the line for Mount Altius. Is Utgun Yagoldsog. This for a four-point lead, which he fails to... Oh, but the offensive rebound! Poor hands by the University of Chile. It's still a three-point lead and a foot violation. Well, in the preliminary stage of this competition, Mount Altius lost two games to Srin Akirenovat from Thailand, and they lost to McGill University, who we've seen lost in the first semi-final by 1 point. Chile just cannot get on the board. Almost 2 minutes played, and it's 3-0. Mount Altius fairly comfortable at the moment. And possession to the Mongolian side. Remember, each team can have four players, three of whom are on court. You can sub anytime you like. On the fade. That's good defense this time from the Chilean players. Well, I thought we had a clear out there. Now that would have been a one, just towing the line. Remember, it's 2 points if you score from outside that big arc. 13 is Ekabata Onolabata. Again, the passes inside are so comfortable, so easy. Well, as opposed to the first semi-final, it was a relatively high-scoring game. This is a low-scoring game, and there, Chile up and running with a long, long two. Again, those gasps of admiration from the fans here. One or two of the Chilean players looking around at the officials saying, don't you think that was traveling? But I'll tell you what, it was just two very long steps. And the pull-up jump shot is good, and it's 5-2 to Mount Altius. Well, 5-3, Chile making a fist of this now. Oh, a long two, instant offense there from Mount Altius number 12, Badzolo Burgil. Is the reply? It certainly is. The response is in kind, Emiliano Marquez. It's a two-point game. Under seven to go in this second semi-final. So under 3 minutes to go in the second semi-final, and the Mongolian side leading by three. Oh, there's a holding foul. Well, the old expression in basketball, what, who, me? Let's see where the replay is. Where's the hold? Well, both players holding there. So Vanessa Devlin deemed the fouls have been called on the Mongolian player. Referees Gianluca Mattioli and Vanessa Devlin. Tough job. It really is a tough job refereeing 3-on-3. It's all action. So everything happens so quickly. And it's a very bruising situation when you take the ball inside. Again, the ball inside to that low post player is so easy. And the rebound there for Emiliano Marquez of Chile. Along the baseline, it's an 11-point to 14 deficit that the Chilean players face. A restart for the Mongolian side. Mongolia again, the cry from the crowd as that pass into that low post. On the turnaround, that's a nice move, but well, the rebound there, no boxing out from the Chilean side. That's got to go in. And rebound for Mongolia, 2 minutes and a couple of seconds to go in the second semi-final. The lane opens up. That's a great pass and the rebound and the point. 16-11. That's not what Chile need. The Chilean side, rather. The snapshot with no rebound there. That's what they need, though. 16-12. 100 seconds remaining. Second semi-final. Oh, the rebounder almost got his own rebound there. Oh, sorry, the shooter almost got his own rebound. This is a terrific spectator situation. Massive, great video screen showing all the replays. And we have a timeout. Each team allowed one timeout in regulation. Of course, you can have overtime. If it's if the scores are tied after 10 minutes, we have overtime. Just to remind you, team that's leading after 10 minutes or the first team to 21. I don't think either team's going to get to 21 here. It's a low-scoring game. 16-12 to Monaltius Physical Education Institute from Mongolia. It was a Chile timeout. Just under 90 seconds remaining. The fadeaway shot. And a good rebound for Emiliano Marquez of University of Chile. Well, dribbling in traffic. It's a three-point game now. 75 seconds. Looking to go one-on-one, and it's in. Rolls around and drops in. A minute left. 4-point the lead now for Monaltius. That's got to go in, really. Missed by considerable distance. A big, big rebound there for an Obata. No give and go there. On the fade. And it's in. Surely that's it now. 18-13. And a quick shot from Chile. That's the second time they've done that. They really should take more time over a more balanced offense. Three on the shot clock. It's in, surely that's it. 19-13 with 24 seconds to go. Another snapshot from the University of Chile. And the rebound for Monaltius. Now why take a quick shot? Okay, you've only got 12 on the shot clock, but you under those circumstances, perhaps using them is more appropriate. Well, that's it, I think. 19-13, Monaltius lead, and they'll just tick the clock away. So Monaltius in to the final, and University of Chile have to be happy, or content rather, with the third place game where they will play University of McGill. But it is Monaltius who will go to the final, and they will play against Kragujevac, the Serbian side. So we've had two semi-finals here.
FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.